Larry here once again. I am pulling up all the photos of the 39-inch Mobius Seaview build that I had started in April of 2014 and finished in February 2015. So I started the build with the control room. I used the Paragraphics photo etch to add some added detail to the control room. Things like the little fence around the flying sub port, the platform around the periscope, some map table details, the ladder behind the periscope platform, a few other things. A lot of it, sadly, you don't see. One of the added details I wanted to do to this control room was light up the individual winkies and blinkies, you know, the computer wall, the control consoles, stuff like that. My bad was that while this thing was sitting on the table and I was doing this, I never realized that a lot of this you would not see looking through the viewport of the sub. So a lot of this detail that you see here is not visible through the viewport of the nose of the submarine, which is kind of sad. There's a lot of detail went into it. So the lighting was done with two individual circuit boards. Each circuit board had three sets of lights that blinked at random. I ran the fiber randomly to the controls to each one of the lights so that they gave a random blinking effect. Sadly, I do not have any video of when I did this back in 2014. Alright, these next couple of pictures show the photo etch that comes with the Paragraphics set. They add the girders in the ceiling that the kit does not provide. It does add a nice bit of detail to the kit, so kind of well worth it. So the next several pictures show the assembled control room sitting on top of the flying sub bay. You'll also notice the board sitting in the back that's running the lights for the control room. Like I said, the flying sub bay has been assembled. The lights have been assembled in the manta ray wings, plus the nose light. So this assembly is complete and ready to be installed in the sub. And here I got a little figure basically staring out the viewport of the sub, just to kind of give a little bit of scale. Here I applied a light diffusion ceiling over the control room just to eliminate any hot spots from the LEDs that will be illuminating the control room. I remember debating on whether to cut up the hull of this ship to install the photo etch for the limber holes. Literally debated for a week or so before I made up my mind to do it. I watched Boyd over there at Trekworks, how he installed the photo etch inside the Enterprise for the officer's lounge and that. And that kind of gave me the confidence to do this and how the technique on how to do this. So that first cut into this was crazy. Man, you talk about an anxiety tech. But I did it and it came out well. So after cutting the hole through the hull and inserting the photo etch, you tape it in place so that it is flush with the hull. I super glued the few corners so that it held its place in the hull, then went back and epoxied in each part of the seam, and as you see, it came out fairly well. A little bit of puttying was needed around the joint line between the two, and then it sanded out and it came out good. And here I applied the same technique, applying the photo etch to the rear of the hull for the limber holes. So, same technique, sand, putty, come out well. In some of the screenshots, you see some subtle detail on the back wall of the flying sub. Here I added, what looks like a door and maybe some control pieces. And then my holes for lighting it. I chose to light this in a red, as we've seen sometimes on screen. So, just detail. In the photo etch set, they give you two drain vents that go between the rear engines. Same technique applies. Cut your opening, glue them, putty them in, blend into the hull. Comes out well. The kit comes with the intake vents molded into the engine halves. I wanted to open them up and show some depth into the engine. So essentially, basically what I did was I cut it out and then applied my own vanes into each half of the engine so that it looks like it's taking in gulps of water to propel this thing through the sea. The Mobius kit gives you two sets of windows to allow you to build it after the 8-foot model or the 17-foot model. I chose to build mine after the 8-foot model, and I believe the distinction was the frames around the window. And if you owned one of these, or if you're building one of these, then you know what kind of a problem the seams are. So, I do remember using a very heavy grit sandpaper to get the plastic to blend together as these pieces were glued together. But with a little bit of elbow grease and some finesse, you start out coarse sandpaper and, work it down to, 400 grit, 600 grit. Maybe some 800 grit after that, and the seam lines can be blended in. But it does take a lot of elbow grease. I made up a custom mix of paint to paint the upper part of the Seaview. I must have mixed up paint 5 different times in order to get the color I kind of wanted. First it was a little too blue, then it was a little too dark. It was just insane trying to get the final color right. And as you will see in the pictures that follow, depending on the lighting, depends on the blueness of the ship or the grayness of the ship. And trying to match the color that we saw on our screen was problematic because, underwater shots, different lighting, different ships. It all played into, how it looked. And I wanted something that looked close to what I saw on TV. So, I think I found it. There is a subtle gray stripe that runs along the length of the limber holes. It's not stark, it's just subtle. For the underside, I used like a light gray right out of the rattle can, and it came out pretty well. I uber detailed this mini flying sub. I bought the photo etch from Paragraphics for this thing. The only thing that lacked with the Paragraphics stuff is that they didn't provide any details for the wall. And it was such a pain to try to paint it. So what I wound up doing was bought the JT Graphics kit, scanned it, and made a decal to apply to the walls. So I'm throwing it out there to you guys. Somebody make a set of details for the Paragraphics photo etch so that the walls can look somewhat decent, you know, rather than trying to paint a thimble. So I have 5 lights, mini lights, inside this thing. One for each one of the spotlights, one for the interior, one for the reactor wall in the back, and then one for the red lights on the engine. I also robbed a couple of figures from the Seaview and installed them in the seats of this flying sub. So the result came out extremely well. The photo etch has the cage, you know, for the inside of the flying sub, as well as the walls around it. Overall, I was very pleased with the way that this thing came out. And as I tried to get some decent pictures looking inside, it really came out better than I expected. So, not that this was going to be the centerpiece of the display. I just wanted it to really shine. So, I also had this kit from Paragraphics. This is the C-Lab, and it's a companion to the flying sub. I knew I wanted to display it with the Seaview and the flying sub, so I added a floor to it, some details. I took some of the photo etch from the Seaview Paragraphics, you know, the chairs, the table, and robbed a figure, stuck the figure in a window, all just to kind of give it some detail. I lit it with some yellow lights to kind of simulate that underwater murkiness instead of a bright white light, so that's why the color is a little bit off, but I was pretty happy with it, the way it came out. The yellow was an off yellow, again, to kind of simulate being underwater. You didn't see that bright, bright yellow. You know, it's evident, like, with the flying sub scenes. So, but overall, I'm happy with the way it came out. And like I said, I lit it and painted it accordingly, so it looked like it was underwater. Okay, once I had the components of the model build, I needed a base that was going to be big enough to support it all. So I started out with some crown molding with the rope detail. You can buy this at Home Depot. The top was just a piece of paneling that was glued to the crown molding, and that provided the solid base. Alright, what you see here is some randomly placed dowels up underneath the screen that is stapled to the display paneling. This will give the effect of a rolling seafloor, so that the floor is a little bit interesting. when it's covered with plaster, it provides a nice effect. To simulate the rocks, I have a mold from like scenic thing, you know, for the railroad people. So I made a bunch of rocks, painted it. I painted the seafloor in a murky gray. If you've ever seen the documentary from James Cameron's The Abyss, all that was done not underwater, but it was done artistic. And essentially what they did was paint the colors in a murky underwater tone. And that's kind of what I was shooting for on the seabed. Alright, so here you can see how I'm positioning the C-Lab on the display base. I was also kind of figuring out some detail that needed to go along with the C-Lab to make it look like that it wasn't just a model plopped down on the seafloor. So I added some piping and whatnot to the base to simulate, you know, like it was geothermal, I don't know, whatever. But anyway, just to kind of give it some detail, it made it interesting. So. All right, one of the things I wanted to convey when I laid out the Seaview, I wanted it kind of in a dynamic situation. A lot of my friends don't watch sci-fi. In fact, they probably don't even know what this is. So I wanted to display it with all the components so that it looked like it was doing something. So as you can see here, how I laid it out with the C-Lab in the corner, with the flying sub kind of doing an alley-oop like it was going to come up and dock with the C-Lab. Like I said, I did not want a static looking display. I wanted something to convey, you know, the essence of the show. One of the other things that the camera picks up as the lighting changes, the color of the ship changes. This is, you know, indicative of the way the show was. So this was a nice little subtle opportunity that happened with the mixing of the paints. So I was kind of happy the way this came out. This is probably one of my favorite shots of the model, just the way that it all came together. Here again, I have some close-ups of the flying sub. I was really happy the way this thing came out. You can see a lot of the detail. The camera's not picking it up. Here's a screen grab of the Seaview with the red lighting in the flying sub bay. And here's a shot of mine. Came out pretty good. Here again, a couple more screen grabs of the flying sub bay and just some of the subtle details you can see inside. And, you know, a little bit of comparison with the one that I did. Overall, I'm kind of happy the way it came out. I like the red light instead of the white. This picture shows a really good shot of the subtle gray along the limber holes, and I believe that is the 8-foot model. All right, here's a couple of screen grabs of the 18-foot and the 8-foot Seaview. Again, just showing the chameleon-like effect of the color of the ship. It was just, it's really hard to grab, you know, what the exact color was off a screen. So, you know, I guess you could say there's no wrong color, you know, unless you're a rivet counter. All right, so these next couple of pictures were shot with different lighting just to kind of emphasize the color differences of strong lighting versus, you know, normal lighting. And this is the way the original model was. All right, just some random shots trying to take pictures of the interior of the control room there. Very difficult to get up close and with a camera without it trying to focus on something else. So, you know, like I said, the detail is limited of what you can see. So, you know, when I over detailed the control room, I was disappointed when this is all I could see through the window. So if you're building one of these, just kind of pay attention to what you're going to see through the windows. You know, save the energy, save the time. Do what you can, only what you can see through the window. So that's my lesson to you guys. You know, like I said, I spent probably weeks on the control room, and you know, I was disappointed after all I could see was just a little bit. So, but I know it's there. I have the pictures I showed you. So anyway, save the energy. Just a couple of shots of the intakes on the engine that I cut out and added some fins, added some nice detail. Here's the underside. You can barely see it, but you got the drain vents there. So, and the rear lighting on the tail fins. It's something I didn't show very well. So.